In this clip, we're going to talk about the proper service procedure for removing and reinstalling your vehicle's radiator. In this step, we're going to talk about the proper procedure for reinstalling your vehicle's radiator. Now, if you happen to be replacing your radiator and you're putting in a new one, you're going to want to make sure that the lower fan shroud clips are on your new radiator. If they're not, it's okay to go ahead and switch them over. They just slip off. You can slip them right back on. You're going to also want to make sure that your mounting screws and vibration grommets are switched over. Most new radiators will come with those replacement components. However, if yours does not, make sure that you switch them over. From here, we're just going to take and gently slide our radiator down into the engine compartment. What we're aiming for, we want to line up our radiator studs with the rubber isolating washers in the bottom. They're just going to slip in just like so. You'll know when you have it aligned correctly because it'll do just like it did there and drop right in place. What I'm going to do now is take and start my radiator mounting nuts. You're going to want to start both of them before you tighten one of them down. Just being that if you have one of them tight, you may not be able to align the other one properly. All right. Once you have them both started, you can take your ratchet and go ahead and tighten the bolts down. Take care not to over-tighten these bolts. They're not hardened, and you are screwing into a very small metal clip or a part of the body. And they don't make these bodies the way they used to. It's pretty thin sheet metal. You're also making a sandwich between the head of the bolt and this Bakelite plastic of your radiator. That stuff's extremely hard, but being that it's extremely hard, it's also extremely brittle. You can crack it and damage the radiator if you over-tighten them. Right there. From there, you're just going to give it a wiggle, make sure it's secure and that it's not going to vibrate. Once you've secured that, that is the proper way to replace your radiator.